Hi everyone, this is Ezekiel from Unbox Stimulant. Welcome to this video. Today I'm reviewing the Tecno P5, a 6-year-old phone that I have used for 6 years, and today I'm going to give a review after all that time and see what is good about the phone, whether you can still buy it, whether you can still go for it or not, and then you can see about that. This phone had some very good specs back then in 2013. It had a 5-megapixel back camera. It also had a 2-megapixel front camera. It packs the 4GB internal storage, but roughly I get around 2GB to 3.5GB because of the installed apps and the system. It also have a 512 MB of RAM. That's very, very low comparing the time we have now. It packs a MediaTek MT6572, a dual core processor, clocked at 1 GHz. It uses the Android 4.2 Jelly Bean, a Node time. It also have a you can expand the storage up to 32 GB of storage, and the rest of the specs are on the screen for your review. So let's first have the physical overview. On the front we have the Tecno logo. You also have the navigation bars. They are not inside the screen as we find right now, they are outside. On the top we have a 3.5 mm headphone jack. We also have a micro USB port. On the right we have a power button key here. On the bottom we have nothing. On the left side we have the volume lockers. We have the up and down volume controls. On the back we have a 5-megapixel camera, just as I have said. We also have a LED flashlights. We also have this one tiny here. This is a noise cancellation microphone. We also have a Tecno logo at the back, and here on the bottom is where we find the speakers. The speaker was very poor by now because I don't know whether it's fall on water or what, but the speaker is almost inaudible for now. So let's open the phone and see what we have in. So this is the phone itself. So you can see it. It's a very small screen. It's actually a 4-inch TFT screen, clocked at, it has a 480 pixels. It's not even HD screen, but by then you can actually see that it was not a bad screen by then. But for now, bearing in mind we have the 4K screens and the 2K screens, so this one now is a bit so much outdated. So let's go to settings and see what we have. Let's start with the storage. You can see that I have a micro SD because the storage that was there was very inappropriate. Out of that 4GB, I get around 3.72 GB. Bearing in mind, I have not installed so many apps. Most of them I have uninstalled them. So let's go to about the phone. So there we go. It's Tecno P5 and it's running on Android 4.2 Jelly Bean, as you can see here, a long time Android version. So let's go back and check the camera. Just have a say that on the front we have a 2-megapixel front camera. We also have HDR, that is very good for now. And at the back we have a 5-megapixel camera, and on the front it's 2-megapixel. So if you go to the settings, we can see all these settings here. If you go here at the camera settings, we have face detection, self timer, continuous shots, and the pixel size is up to 5 megapixels. Sorry about that. Let's go here to the video, and this surprising guys, and that we have electronic image stabilization EIS. Bearing in mind this phone is very old and that's very good. I'll keep it on for now. Most of the phones now at around 7k to 10,000 Kenya shillings, you cannot get any electronic image stabilization. Now to get this one, now you have to spend around 20,000 and more to get it. So I think this thing Tecno did it very well. I don't know why these days they are not doing it. I hope Tecno think about that. The video quality, we have low, medium, high and fine. For the fine, it's a 720p. For the high, it's a 480 pixels, and for the medium is very low quality, around 360p. So let's go back now and exit the camera app. By the way guys, I'll provide a sample images at the end of this video and a sample video so that you can guess and see the pictures themselves. So let me tell something about the audio so that you can hear about what I'm talking about. Let me just look for an audio here. Actually, you cannot even hear it. It's very low. You hear? It's even very, very low. You can actually not hear it. Actually, this phone, I cannot listen to music unless I use earphones. And still, the reception is not very good. You get, this is a dual SIM, and it's a 3G connection. It's actually 3.75G. And unless you are in a very good network area, the connection is not that great. And 4G is not available. Also about the earpiece, about my, I think it's not the whole of Tecno P5, but I think it's my unit that had a problem with the earpiece. I can actually not hear what the other person on the other side is talking. So I've been having a problem in communication with this phone because I cannot hear the communication. I actually use it for messaging nowadays. I don't use it to call because it does not help at all. But I would say that another thing I would like to point out is that thing about the camera, the electronic image stabilization, that was very good. And I was able to take videos that are not shaky, that are a bit stable, and pictures are also stable, and you see that at the end of the video, and that was very good. So generally, to sum it all, this was a good phone. 4-inch screen, 480 pixels TFT screen, 3.75G, very good phone by then. But now more phones have come out, and very good, with very good specs, with almost, you can do everything with the phone. Everything have a very strong processor, the Snapdragons and the MediaTek Helio P70s and the like, and this technology, and this how it's evolving. So guys, I think that this have been good, and I hope you have enjoyed this video. At the end here are the sample pictures and the sample video, so that you sorry guys, so that you can see for yourself how the camera is good on this phone. So subscribe to my channel, hit on that little bell, notification bell there, and share this video with everyone you may like, you who likes the video, and anyone else, and I will see you on my next one. Thanks guys.